CanWest Broadcasting is at the front edge of a revolution. That's just a hint of where we're going as pioneers in the new world of digital media. And here's what we're leaving behind: tired old sets and analog tools ill-equipped to serve our ever-expanding and demanding audiences.
Global National with Kevin Newman.
We've come a long way. Today, Global National's anchor Kevin Newman sits in a state-of-the-art virtual environment thousands of kilometers away from the production center, connected to the rest of Canada by a sophisticated broadband network.
Good evening. Thank you for joining us.
Quebec and the Maritimes were not far behind. In just 2 months, they joined Global National as the first of our local news operations to go fully digital.
Now with our first look at the forecast, and Anthony, this is what summer should feel like, I think.
But that is just part of our remarkable transformation. We are building brand new facilities in every single market. Here's one of our production centers under construction. And here is the first of the production center news control rooms, now in operation in Vancouver. From here, we will put to air the newscasts from Victoria, Winnipeg, and Montreal, plus Global National. A similar broadcast center in Toronto will support Hamilton, Regina, and Saskatoon, while Edmonton picks up the Maritimes and Red Deer. Calgary will support Lethbridge and the Fox Sports World team based in Winnipeg. Using Montreal as an example, this is how the net pipe makes it all possible. The feeds include the two studio cameras and a third feed for other elements such as live remotes. The camera shots are of the anchor sitting at a real desk in a green room. The cameras are controlled remotely by an operator in Vancouver, and the virtual set is inserted from the Vancouver control room. The production is then fed live on NetPipe to Calgary Master Control, where it is then delivered via NetPipe back to the local market and out to our audience via the local transmitter. All of the local news reports are sent ahead of time from Montreal over NetPipe to Vancouver, where they're converted back to digital video clips for playback during the newscast. And from Victoria, right across the country to Halifax, we're installing digital newsroom systems. A system designed by Grass Valley in consultation with our own engineering, production, and editorial teams. Content can now be shared across all our operations via the NetPipe with the click of a mouse. Our new non-linear edit system allows us to unleash our creative juices and dramatically enhance the production values of our storytelling. And no more waiting for tape. With our network of servers, content in production can be assessed simultaneously by many users without disrupting production timelines. After all, one thing that hasn't changed is deadlines. And speaking of storytelling, here's what the real set looks like to us in the new world. The most advanced robotic systems employing an ingenious H-frame mechanism allows us to turn this small green box into this. And so far, we've only scratched the surface. Thanks to this groundbreaking technology, we will ensure a long-term future in delivering news and information not only on conventional television, but online, wireless, and multiple digital platforms. Welcome to the adventure.
Well, hi there, everybody who is getting ready to join us in this great virtual world of Globals. This is my green room, and it is a little scary, yes, the color, but if you watch the magic that they do in Vancouver, you will see that they turn it into an absolutely fabulous set. And I can tell you, we were very nervous about it here in Quebec, but it has worked out fine. We were the first ones locally to go online after the National did it. And there were a lot of rehearsals where there was plenty of nail biting and a lot of nerves, but I have to tell you that all the good folks in Vancouver took really good care of us. They gave us everything that we needed, and we're so thrilled with how our set ultimately looks. As you can see, our lighting is the best in this city, and I'd argue probably the best across the country, because we have like the primo lighting guy who came in here and spent a lot of time with us. And we also at the same time went digital in our editing system, so our guys had a huge learning curve there, but now we're a couple of months in and everybody's getting used to it. Like any new thing, there have been glitches, there have been issues, but we've gotten through them all positively, and I have to give a big thank you to all the folks in Vancouver who held our hand through this and really got it going for us. We're very happy with the results now, so thanks a lot. Thank you all. And it's, you know what? It's very true. I wasn't just sucking up. So thank you all again.